I'm Rob Randolph. I just graduated from Lipscomb University with a Bachelor of Arts in Bible and Youth Ministry. I'm engaged to the beautiful Sally Taylor, and I am very excited about being your youth ministry intern this summer.
Hi, I'm Laura Jean Plunkett. I'm a junior at Faulkner University, and I'm from Montgomery, Alabama. I also date the most beautiful boy in the state of Alabama, Cody Andrew Bell, and I'm excited to be your youth intern this summer. Working in the office and feeling a little awkward with the staff, we felt like it was our job to really try to get to know them on a deeper level, the staff and the kids, and really put our best foot forward and being fun and having a good time with them.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
I've enjoyed getting to know Rob. I mean, he's okay, I guess. It's just, when we go places in public, it's kind of embarrassing. He's really clumsy, like awkwardly clumsy. Falls on people, in large crowds. It's funny, it really is, but it's really embarrassing when you're the one hanging out with him. I want to really be his friend, but sometimes it's just kind of embarrassing.
And I've enjoyed getting to know her over the past week or so and hanging out with her, but sometimes it's difficult to have a conversation with her. Sometimes we'll just be talking and... Sometimes when I'm talking with her, she just randomly falls asleep in the middle of the conversation. Just in the most random places, too. And I'm not even sure if she knows, because she'll fall asleep and she'll wake back up and just keep on talking like she never even stopped. I think she's narcoleptic, but I'm not sure how I should tell her.
Sleepy eyes, baby cries. You're too small to wonder why. Wrap the band of slumber round your sleepy eyes. Sleepy eyes, tired sighs, yawning as the daylight dies. Sleep won't dim the dawn inside those sleepy eyes. Won't you cease and just release and stop this hopeless fighting, please? Sleepy eyes, your disguise cannot fool me with its lies. Let the angels come and close your sleepy eyes.
We just have so much to do in the office today, like getting stuff ready for work camp, for pancake breakfast, for...
Laura Jean. Hey, Laura Jean, I just got done talking to George and Courtney about the summer theme. They told me all about it. It's gonna be awesome. The summer theme is gonna be... Orgy, you're right.
I wonder what it would be like if instead of me falling asleep everywhere...
And me falling down all the time.
We could get everyone together to fall in line.
Take the field now, unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting, as we lose our inhibition. Celebration, it surrounds us, every nation all around us.
Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's interns, take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting, as we lose our inhibition. Celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation, all around us.
Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day, we all say,
when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave. And when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a wave.
Lives are in constant risk of slip-ups, failures, struggles, and grief. We are in a bumpy road with major risks of stumbling, tripping, and falling.
We are living in a world that desires our mistakes, rejoices in our failures, smiles at pain, and runs after evil. But what if we chose differently? What if instead of falling into the grip of the enemy, we fall in love with Jesus?
What does that look like? Why should we choose to fall into anything? Wouldn't that risk us getting hurt, failing, letting go of the familiar comforts of our lives?
When you fall into line with the enemy, pain exists with no peace. Failures come with no way out, and destruction occurs with no restoration.
But when you fall in line with Jesus, when you line up your life with Christ, what does that look like?
Pain exists, but God gives comfort.
Fear might grip you, but God gives courage.
Hatred may come your way, but God gives love.
The pieces of your life may crumble, but God gives restoration.
Challenges may cause suffering, but God gives strength.
You may slip into sin, but God gives forgiveness.
Chaos may engulf your life, but God gives peace.
Life can leave you stuck with no way out, but God gives freedom.
When we can't, God always can.
When our lives are in line with Christ, we receive a life of rescue from the dark patterns of this world. We are given a chance to do glorious work for the Almighty One who created us. We are given life, and life to the full with Jesus.
Are you willing? Are you ready to fall in?